Hello, ladies and gentlemen. This is a little heads up, no, a little video for your information. I've been very lazy in the last few months, or rather in the last year, when it comes to making videos. This will change. Recently I decided, or I came to the conclusion, that it might be better to restart the lectures about magic. So I will do that. So you can look forward to new videos coming, I hope, more frequent than before. And someone asked me to make a video in which I explain something about my background, because I think I never addressed in a video that very important question: who is that guy, and why is he sitting in front of a camera talking about magic like he knows something? Well, I came to have an interest in magic at a very young age. My brother, he's 12 years older than me, he did some stuff with magic when he was about 20-ish. And one of the guys he used to hang around with at that time was the early 80s. One of those guys was Ralf Tegtmeier. Horrible German name, I know. But there is a Wikipedia article about that guy. On English Wikipedia. He's a German, and only English Wikipedia has an article about that dude. German Wikipedia doesn't have an article about that dude, because I'm active at German Wikipedia, and should an article about that asshole be on German Wikipedia, I will try to get it off Wikipedia. And I know that this video will be used against me should I start some actions against an article about that asshole, Ralf Tegtmeier. Why do I call that asshole asshole? Well, because he is an asshole. That doesn't explain much, I know. Ralf Tegtmeier, also known as Frater UD, that's how he calls himself in the English-speaking parts of the world. In the German-speaking parts, he uses Frater VD, but VD in English means venereal disease, and he doesn't want to be associated with that, although he should. He did some experiments with a friend of mine, friend of my brother's and a friend of mine, very cool guy. That he's a cool guy you can already see with his first name. His first name is Ernie. He doesn't laugh like Ernie, but he's as cool as Ernie. And please don't make jokes about my brother being Bert. Well, that dude, Frater UD tried to teach Ernie something about magic, and the result of that was that at some point my brother's friend just said, "I can't take it anymore," and he went to the next mental institution and stood there for about half a year to get his head fixed. And somebody who says, "I'm gonna teach you about magic," and the result of that is a longer time in a mental institution. Such a person, at least when I'm considered, deserves to be called asshole and worse. So, I was about... I don't really remember how old I was when all that happened, but I must have been 7 or 8 years old. And then I started to learn about the tarot, and when I was 14 I bought my first deck of tarot cards. and kind of immediately started to read the future for my friends. For them, most of the time it was more a game. But some years later we were kind of amazed how accurate my predictions were. Sometimes it was really funny when the most fucked up guy ended up to be a square and to be a guy who was into fashion like nobody else. So at 14 I started to use the tarot for readings, and when I was 18 I started to get into the different areas of high magic, so Kabbalah, ritual magic, invocation, evocation, using of different traditional rituals like the pentagram ritual, alchemy and astrology, and all that stuff. Then I spent 5 years at a university, the Rheinische Friedrich Wilhelms Universität Bonn. A quite good university, I have to say. Comparative religions is a field where you can find many freaks among the students, and some of these students gathered and we founded a little group, a little working group, research group. We did magic in a group, and it was quite an interesting time. But at some point some dude started to make some bullshit, kind of reminded me of Frater UD, and after he attacked, magically attacked some guys, after he tried to use very cheap tricks to turn people into something like slaves, the group fell apart. So I think we worked together for about 2 years. And after that, kind of accidentally, I came to another group of people that worked in all of Germany. And they had, so to speak, regional chapters, and the chapter of the part of Germany where I'm living, Nordrhein-Westfalen, North Rhine-Westphalia, the group of people in North Rhine-Westphalia, they at some point transformed that little group, and the bigger group again broke apart because some dudes wanted to be the big bosses. So we worked in our little group, and eventually that group turned into a lodge, complete with a line of succession to the original Fraternitas Saturni. Multiple lines of succession, I might add. Not only the so-called Emmanuel succession, which is more a joke as it is something else, but there was also at least one other line of succession, maybe even two, all really going back to the founder of the lodge, Gregor A. Gregorius. And without no, not without. I just have to make this little remark. Gregorius met Crowley, so that you could say that is no, you shouldn't say that is a no. Forget that. Don't forget that. Sorry. It's good weather out there and I'm in a good mood. Making videos again. Yeah. What else is there to say? Well, that bloke, I left that lodge after some years, and short time after leaving that lodge I took on the pseudonym of Eliphas Leary, and some years after using that pseudonym on the internet I started making videos, and quite possibly that's where you met me. Well, I should get serious again. My attempts at jokes are not good today. So what else is there to say? Yes, one thing, I'm playing with the thought to make some videos, a kind of new video series about stuff like astrology or the tarot or whatever, so a specialized series on astrology. Please leave comments if you would like to see something like that, or if you would rather not. I learned astrology, so to speak, the hard way. My teacher just gave me the ephemerides, I hope I pronounced that name right, a big book that's only full of numbers. Mathematics. Then he gave me a book of tables and a very, very small thingy that explains how to calculate a horoscope. Then my teacher left me alone with those three books until I figured out how to calculate a horoscope. So sometimes I find myself wondering, why do I call that guy a teacher? And then I recall I'm just making jokes again. Bad jokes. So that's how I learned astrology. I really can calculate horoscopes, and I have problems taking people serious that call themselves astrologers but do not know how to calculate a horoscope. So if you want to learn that, I gladly would do some videos about that. And maybe even if you say no, don't do that, I will make them. Maybe. When I'm in a cruel mood, I will. What else? What did I say in the German version of this? I can't remember. Don't stare into nothingness for too long without saying anything. People will get bored and turn the video off. Why do I say that to myself? Because I want to be funny, but I'm not. So, I think I reached the dead end of this video, so it's better to stop, and I will. See you soon. Enjoy yourselves. Enjoy everything, and yeah, have a good time. Bye.